process that normal way, normal conception process.
And there's no way in science currently that we can balance the genetic distribution that we can limit it to just two. And is it possible in the DNA to remove one of those chromosomes even during probably fertilization? Or I know Nigeria might not really have that process, but do you think it's possible?
No, there's no way you can remove it.
Okay. Now, if there is no special curse, there's no way to remove it. Okay. Now, who are the major people prone to having this disorder?
Okay, thank you. People from age 40 to 40 upward are prone to having this.
Is it male or female?
Both.
Both.
But it's more pronounced in women.
More pronounced in older women who are just about to conceive.
Yes.
So you'd advise early conception.
Thank you.
Okay.
From age 18 to 35. Then worst case scenario, 40.
So you'd advise that older women should not consider conception?
No.
Especially for Down syndrome?
Well, older women are prone to having this condition, children with this condition.
Okay.
But not in all cases.
Definitely not in all cases.
Yes. So it depends on the body makeup.
On the body chemistry of the woman.
Yes.
And
body
whom
system.
She's meeting with.
Yes. Then the generational history of both parents.
Oh, so is Down syndrome hereditary?
Yes.
It's also hereditary?
Yes. It could be traced back to
the lineage.
The lineage of both parents.
Of how far apart we could be talking about first generation, second, third, fourth.
This could be any.
It could be any.
Yes.
Wow. This is Mental Health Show with James Oshintobu. I still have with me Mrs. Balogun Cordelia, who happens to be a special educator and a child mental health advocate, I beg your pardon. We'll be back shortly after this musical break. Let It Be by John Legend featuring Alicia Keys. I love this song so much. Let It Be.
And that everything was going to be okay. It's a song that's comforted generations with its beauty and its message.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom. Let it be.
In my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom. Let it be.
Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Let it be. Whispering words of wisdom. Let it be. And when the broken-hearted people living in the world agree, there will be an answer. Let it be.
For though they may be parted, there is still a chance that they will see. There will be an answer.
Yes, there would be an answer. Let it be. You just need to let it be. This is Mental Health Show with James Oshintobun. We're live on JMP Blizz Radio. You can listen to previous episodes of this show on podcast by simply searching Mental Health Show with James Oshintogun. You can get it on Google Podcasts, you could get it on Spreaker, Spotify, and many more. Or you could just follow me on any of my social media pages, MC Jerry J on Instagram, Twitter, and every other social media. I still have life here, Mrs. Balogun Cordelia, a child mental health advocate and a special educator. Before we went on the musical break, we're talking about the causes and how to try and avert the situation. And you also spoke about the possibility of having to trace it back to previous generations, yes. Which means it is hereditary.
Yes.
Good. Now, what are the physical features that could make us identify and say, okay, these are symptoms of Down syndrome?
Okay, thank you. Some of the features or symptoms could be small ears,
okay,
flat nose, or even flat face.
Oh, okay.
They have that unique look with flat face,
okay,
and flat nose. Then bogging tongue. You see them always trying to bog out their tongue.
Okay.
Then you see they have short necks. Then we have you see them having short hands and feet. Then in some cases you see them having this obesity look.
They then always look loose, obese.
Yes, obese.
Okay.
Then loose joints. You see them very flexible. They are not as agile as regular children without this condition.
Okay.
Then short stature. I don't think I've ever come across a Down syndrome child or persons with
very tall. Big, huge,
yeah,
tall.
Who is tall. They are always short. So these are some of the features you find in them.
Okay. Down syndrome in children gives limitation in language and communication skills,
yes,
cognition, and non-verbal problem-solving abilities. All this definitely makes them vulnerable to many mental health situations. The first of all is discrimination. What would you say about discrimination, especially when you're discriminating special children?
Well, there's no way there won't be discrimination.
Are you saying it's accepted?
Once it's not acceptable.
Okay.
Once you see, for you who is a regular child,
okay,
you know how the regular ones look like.
Definitely.
Then you are seeing a human being just like you, having a different look.
Different facade.
Of course, questions will start popping up. Why is it like this? Why is it like this? Then if you start seeing some funny attitude, behaviors in that child, most people tend to withdraw back. I don't want to play with this child. And because they have issues with development, mental development, they can't communicate well. The way they reason differs. They don't reason according to the normal standard. They don't do things the way they should. People tend to avoid them. But then, these people are sweet to be with if you move close to them and you understand them very well. We used to have this child in our clinic then. I won't mention her name.
Okay.
She has this talent in her. Though she's a Down syndrome person.
Okay.
But then she has this, she can sing.
Okay.
She has the talent of singing.
So you mean people who have Down syndrome could still sing perfectly?
Of course. They have special talents. And that's why we recommend things like therapies like vocational skills, where they go to learn hand skill.
Okay.
Yes. So this particular girl sings well. And then one of the things that pushed me to the clinic whenever I'm down or I don't feel like I'm not just in the mood is because of how she sings. I'll just go there.
She's that good at singing?
She's good. She's that good. If she's singing without you seeing her, you'll be like, wow, I want to meet with this person. It is after meeting with her, I'll be like, oh, she's a special child.
And then you go quite emotional.
Yes. So they are sweet to be with, if you understand them. And if they are being managed the way they should, in fact, they can do things that even the regular children can't.
Wow.
I used to have one in my church then.
Okay.
Who happens to be the breadwinner of the house.
Are you kidding me? How yes. does that particular person happen to fend for the entire family?
She was a shoemaker.
Oh, she.
Can you beat that? Yes.
Okay.
So, she designed all kinds of shoes. And because of her condition,
she attracts more customers.
Yes. She has that's her selling point.
Wow.
So, she happens to be the breadwinner of the house. That's just about the discrimination and...
So, you would advise that because they have the Down syndrome, they should not be ruled out...
At all.
...as being abnormal.
At all.
And then there's still a talent they could showcase.
Yes.
So, definitely, it means anyone who has... a child who has Down syndrome should not give up on the child.
Yes.
And then we can always support them to become even better persons in life.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
And they could live a very meaningful life.
Wow.
Yes.
But for someone who has Down syndrome, even living a meaningful life, one of the parts that will still occur is marriage, matrimony. Mating and giving up offsprings.
Of course.
Do you think they're okay for marriage, especially when they're matured? Or since you said they go five years backwards, sort of, when do you think a Down syndrome person should be matured for marriage on an average?
Well, I won't give a specific age.
Okay.
Like I said, it depends on how you manage them. If you manage some very well, they can go as length as getting married and having good jobs, even giving birth to normal children, if they are properly managed.
But we said Down syndrome is genetic and it is also hereditary.
Yes.
What are the chances that a normal child and a special child coming together to give up an offspring, what are the chances that they won't also put up another special child who has Down syndrome?
That would be a 50-50 chances. For the fact that he or she is having the condition doesn't mean he is going to give birth to a child with the condition.
But definitely it's recorded in their DNA, in their genetics,
yes.
Right?
So the child could now grow
and give
marry
birth to,
and give birth to a Down syndrome child. Do you understand?
But the most interesting part of this is the fact that they could still live their life normally and still make an impact in the society. You could imagine how much this particular lady you're talking about, how much she's contributed to the economy of this country by being a cobbler, making ends meet for herself and the family.
Yes.
Oh, awesome. But come on. Well, if she was not supported by the family, I don't think she would be a breadwinner of the family.
Of course, yes.
There's actually this situation where I heard of this particular story whereby some certain parents, because they've tried all they could to help their child who had Down syndrome, and then they plan to kill her. And one man picked her up and then the man